Dear students, we are going to continue the module 1. This is going to be lecture 9 video in module 1. So in this one, we are going to discuss the machine dependent features. In this one, we will be studying the instruction format and addressing most of SIC bar XC machine. So here, see machine dependent assembler features. So if an operand is prefixed with add rate, then it is called indirect addressing. So in the program, line number 70 it is given. We will be seeing in the coming slides. Then if it is prefixed with the hash, then it is called immediate operands. If the operand is prefixed with hash, then it is called immediate operand. If in the program, if any instruction, if the base assembler directive it is there, then it is called base relative addressing. If operand is prefixed with plus, if opcode is prefixed with plus, then it is called extended format of, which will be of format 4. Then the use of register instruction, it belongs to format 2, and faster and don't require another memory reference. So one more slide here, we register with this one only in short part. If operand is followed by, if opcode is followed by operand, then it is called, it can be a PC relative or base relative. If opcode is followed by @rate, then it is called indirect addressing. If opcode is followed by hash, then it is called immediate addressing. If opcode is prefixed with plus and followed by operand, then it is called extended format of format 4. If opcode is followed by operand comma x, then it is called index addressing. And if register to register instruction is there, then it will be of length 2. So you can see that first, second, third and third, it will be of format 3. So 3 bytes instruction length will be there. This it is called extended format, it is a 4 byte length. And this is index addressing, it is of 2, it is also of 3 bytes, and compare, this is of 2 bytes. So you remember, operand followed by hash, it is immediate addressing. Operand followed by address, it is of indirect addressing. And in here some registers are there, which already we have studied in the beginning: AXLBSTFPCNSW. Its symbol is 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Now let's see here one more instruction. It has a 4 SIC bar XC. It supports a 4 types of instruction format. First, it is of 1 byte of 8 bits. Then format 2, which is of 16 bits or 2 bytes. So first 8 bits is for opcode, then 4 bit for register 1 and 4 bit for register 2. Then format 3, it will be having 3 bytes, means 24 bits. So first bit is for opcode, then NIXBPE. N is stand for indirect and indirect mode, I immediate mode, and X index addressing, B base addressing, P program counter, and E exponential addressing. Then format 4 of 4 bytes, 32 bits. So first 6 bit is for opcode, then NIXBPE address. Let us see here. In this one, this is our program, and we are going to generate the object code for this in using the SIC bar XC. Now see in this one. So as we know that object code cannot be generated directly. It will be in two parts. First one, first location counter will be generated. then pass through that object code will be generated. So let us see, there start opcode is start, and one more thing is that we have whichever of a similar directory for that object code will not be generated. So here start is the a similar directory, so there is no object code. Similarly base is also object, it's a similar directory, no object code. And similarly by reserve word, reserve word, reserve byte, they are also a similar directory, there is no like object code for this. Here byte is the assembler directory, this is the ASCII value of end of all. E has a hexadecimal ASCII value 45, then O has 4F, and then F has 46. Now we'll see the first line, it is the first STL return address. Since here opcode is start, its address seems 0, so we'll start with 0. Then store and load return address, it is of format 3. Opcode followed by operand, which is just now we saw in the previous slide. Opcode followed by operand, it is of PC relative or base relative. So but it will be of format 3 of 3 bytes. So 3 bytes will be added here, 0. Then LDB hash length, it is the immediate addressing, which is also of format 3 of 3 bytes will be added here. So 3 plus 3, 6. This one is not right because base is a similar directory. Then length is again opcode followed by operand, so 3 bytes will be added, so 3 plus 6 plus 3 3 plus 3 6. Now plus j sub, so it is extended version. We just in the previous slide we saw that if the opcode is prefixed with the plus, then it is called extended addressing mode, which is of 4 bytes. So 4, 6 plus 4, 8. Similarly, this opcode followed by operand, it is 3 bytes, so 3 will be added. Compare hash, it is also immediate addressing mode of 3 bytes, so it will be d plus 3, 10. And like that only, here also plus j sub is there, so here also it is extended, so 4 bytes is there, so here 3 plus 4, 70. Like that, all these things again here plus 2, so 26 plus 4 is 28, will represent like that. Then again here some another instructions are there, register to clear X, means opcode followed by register. So it's a clear mnemonic value of clear opcode is B4 and X it is a 10. In clear it is a B4, A it is 00. Clear it is a B4, S it is 00. So we will finish till here. In the next session we will be trying to know how to convert this return address. Thank you.